Smart irrigation controllers help reduce water use by making automatic adjustments to irrigation schedules based on environmental feedback. This information is commonly gathered using on-site sensors. These include solar, rain, freeze, wind, flow, and soil moisture sensors. Solar sensors measure the surrounding air temperature as well as sunlight intensity to allow the controller to adjust watering schedules appropriately. If the day is cloudy and cool, irrigation cycle runtimes may be shortened. And if the day is especially sunny and hot, they may increase to counter the effects of evapotranspiration, or ET. ET is the process by which water moves from the Earth's surface to the atmosphere through evaporation and by transpiration from the plants. Rain sensors, as you might expect, measure rainfall. Based on how much precipitation has been measured, the controller will interrupt irrigation cycles until the sensor dries out enough for the controller to return to its regular schedule. Rain sensors will either use a collection cup or expansion discs that absorb water to measure precipitation. Sensitivity can be adjusted so the user can choose how much accumulation is needed in order to trigger the interruption. Freeze sensors are used to prevent irrigation cycles from running when ambient temperature is near the point of freezing. In addition to helping to prevent damage to plant life, it can help to prevent hazardous conditions for pedestrians and drivers as a result of ice formation from overspray. Freeze sensors are commonly combined with rain sensors to provide a dual-purpose accessory. Wind sensors help to prevent wasted water as a result of drift due to windy conditions. Like the other weather sensors we've discussed, wind sensors will interrupt the program irrigation schedule if conditions are extreme enough to make sprinklers ineffective. Wasted water and damage to landscapes in the event of a leak in an irrigation system is another problem that can be prevented with a sensor. Flow sensors and hydrometers monitor the flow of each zone in the system, which allows the controller to learn how much water is used during each cycle. If excess flow is detected compared to the learned flow, as in the case of a break or leak in the system, the controller will send out an alert through email, text message, or through an app on a mobile device. Some controllers will even interrupt the irrigation cycle. Finally, information collected from soil moisture sensors can also be used to influence irrigation. Soil moisture sensors are buried in a strategic area of the landscape to monitor moisture levels of the soil. The controller uses this data to determine if irrigation is required and will prevent the schedule from running if there's adequate moisture detected in the soil. All of the sensors we've shown, as well as other landscape and irrigation products that can help you water more efficiently, can be found at your local Ewing branch. To find a location near you or to shop online, visit us at ewingirrigation.com.